So we hear a lot about the severe impairments that autism brings. And indeed, sometimes they're really very serious and sometimes devastating behavioral problems that we can observe. But we mustn't forget at the same time that there are also some extremely interesting qualities in the very different mind of the autistic person that brings great strength and indeed talent. So it is very good to appreciate the talent that occurs in autism, even though people will immediately point out, well, it's only a minority of autistic people who show their talent. But I would say to this, yes, it is a minority, but it is a very substantial minority. So let's talk some rough numbers. About 10% of people with autism have a very notable, definite talent in some area. It could be music, it could be art, it could be math, it could be calendar calculation. Of these 10%, perhaps there are a few hundred, maybe only 100, who are in a group by themselves, in the kind of group where people rush to them and make television programs about them, and they are on the web, and you might well know examples of these absolutely extraordinary people who stand out with their abilities. So one of them, for example, is Gregory Blackstock, who you can see on the web, who does the most superb drawings of collections of things, birds and tools and animals, vegetables, minerals, and here's an example of many different kinds of radishes that he draws and names. He calls it the rounded world of radishes, and we've chosen this actually for the cover of our book, Autism and Talent, that Francesca Happe and I edited recently, specifically in an attempt to draw attention to the extraordinary talent that occurs in autism, and also to draw attention to the fact that it's still one of the least understood features about autism. So what is it about, say, the art of an autistic artist such as Gregory Blackstock? Well, there is, for example, we find a disregard of convention. These people are not hampered by the conventions that we are all very much under. We see often very original and creative art in young children, and they are still not so constrained by all the conventions. And that is one of the advantages and one of the beauties of art and expression in autism. There is much less preoccupation with appearance, with social nicenesses. So the person, and indeed the person's brain, can devote specialist areas to just develop one particular skill, possibly at the expense of others, but it could be very similar to what we see, for example, in an athlete who practices one particular skill day after day and becomes absolutely incredibly competent in this. Without the practice, it couldn't be done. There is an idea that if you are less self-conscious, and again, I remind you here perhaps of children, young children who are unself-consciously producing often wonderful creative art, that this unself-consciousness is perhaps one of the positive sides of what otherwise are very great disadvantages of not reflecting about yourself and how you affect other people. So you can be in the flow, in this sort of subconscious flow of doing something without monitoring this very, very consciously, which has sometimes been considered a very strong aspect of talent, that you can really produce this. So, in other words, we're still in front of a great mystery, and we would love research to be moving forward in this particular area, because it is something that has great benefit for the families of people with autism, even for those families who don't have children who exhibit these talents, because it does tell us all that we still need to explore our minds and what it is capable of, and the key to some of the most mysterious and interesting aspects of our mind might actually lie within individuals with autism.